What is the problem with today's large lecture halls? Students in large classroom settings feel anonymous, which makes it more likely that they won't pay attention to the lecture. A typical solution would be to improve the lecture by becoming more charismatic, rhetorically skilled, funny, interesting, including explosions, and so on. However, studies have shown that retention rate is still relatively low, and that at best, students' feeling of learning is improved, even if actual learning is not. So, why don't students learn what we are so desperately trying to make attractive to them? We need a paradigm shift. What we need to do is to activate their brains. Instead of focusing on the lecture, rather ask yourself, what are my students doing while I talk? Are they actively engaging with the material or passively listening and absorbing information? Spend less time worried about yourself as a lecturer and more time considering a student-centered approach. Studies have shown that conceptual understanding is improved if students have time to consider the material themselves. This makes them feel uncomfortable, which may be reflected in bad evaluations, but they do learn more. Giving students a chance to grapple with the content of your lecture during the lecture can take this general form. First, you break up the lecture into smaller pieces. Each concept should be about 5 to 15 minutes of you talking. Between these chunks, allow time for students to engage with the material. Even as little as 1 to 2 minutes can be effective. To do this, first pose a question or a series of questions, and then allow time for activation. During these activation sessions, students can participate in some variation of think, pair, share, a teaching method developed by Frank Lyman of the University of Maryland. First, allow students to consider the question on their own. This forces students to be actively engaged with the material. Then, allow students to form pairs or small groups to discuss the question. This leverages the social aspect of learning. Students get to know one another, they even create study groups, and this also improves learning. Students talk to each other on the same level. They can identify common misconceptions of their peers and explain correct thinking using terminology that is accessible to them. At the same time, students practice using technical vocabulary and formulating questions, thereby improving their capability to understand the concepts. Finally, ask a pair or a group to share their answer with the class. Having discussed it first with their peers empowers them to feel more confident in their answer. The student speaking does not need to take individual ownership of a wrong or otherwise embarrassing answer. Reshaping your lecture to include more activation time for students is often referred to as a student-centered approach to teaching and learning, a key part of which is the activation of students. The more chances a student has to interact with the course material instead of passively absorbing the information, the deeper and more profound the learning. For more information about specific techniques to implement these concepts in a large classroom setting, please check out our next video, or don't hesitate to contact us.